Hello, Flight Simmers. Spanker, episode 12, my round world tour. And we last landed at San Antonio. So we've got the route planned here in Sky Vector for today. We are going to fly east out of San Antonio via Dimmer. I can't even see what that says because of the plan. Not to worry. Anyway, Sierra Alpha Victor Victor, we'll call it that. Flight out of there, probably touch and go at that airport before we head roughly northeast to Bahia Blanca, Sierra Alpha Zulu Bravo. Quick look at this airport. So it's a long runway, 8,000 feet, concrete. There we go. So it looks like there's a racetrack next to it. Maybe that's horse racing. Or it could be another racetrack. That looks like a sort of, what do they call them? Speedway, not a speedway. That's definitely a racetrack, isn't it? And then the town is further north. Very organised how they laid out Argentinian towns, noticed. Just flip back, let's have a look at this airport we're landing at. Okay, so another long runway. Base Aero Naval, so it looks like a Navy base. Museum of Aviation, Naval Aviation Argentina. Interesting. So the runway's quite long there. And a big, big town here. Again, all immaculately organised. Quite a large port. Looks interesting. I doubt it'll be modelled. Can we drop into one of these streets at random? Pretty much similar to every other street. In fact, you could mistake this for Spain. I suppose the heritage is there. Anyway, back to it. That's a route. That's where we're going. 227 miles in total. I haven't checked the weather yet, but I will do, and I will go and start it up and see on the taxi. Just backtracking down the runway, San Antonio. Light wind of 8 knots, just off the runway. No taxiways here, obviously I was stuck on grass and had to put in about 50% of power to get it moving. Off the grass. Altimeter's set, flaps are set for takeoff, trims are in the green. Landing lights are on. So we're ready to go. The route's planned into the GPS. Give it the beans. Trees again. Rotator at 90. Going up, gear up. Easy. Bring the flaps up and let's turn onto course. About 7,000 feet, I think. So autopilot's on, your damp is on. Autopilot at the moment is just going to do our altitude, and then we can flip it into nav mode. First, I want to change this CDI to GPS. There we go. And then if I flip that into nav, autopilot's taking us where we need to go, and then I'm just going to kick it up into, I don't know why that weren't set full, 850 mode, get full power of the engine, kick the landing lights off. Go 91 miles to our first airport, and about 22 minutes. That should come down as we get higher and faster. Done a few little changes to the scenery. I had the Orbix Global Base installed. I had Vector, but I'd never installed it, so I've installed Global Vector now, which doesn't do much. It tidies up some of the issues with roads and coastlines, apparently. I'm not sure if it's noticeable. I'll have to look that back on one of the last vids and see if it's there's any noticeable difference. As of yet, not much that I can see. Okay, we're climbing up to a cruise altitude. I will cut back in on the approach to our first runway. We're 5 minutes or so away from the first airport. We're still at 7,000 feet. Got a bit of weather. It's been a bit of cloud, it's been very blustery. I'm just going to going to start a descent now. Just going to let the autopilot take us down. See if we can spot that runway. Wind's behind us, so might do an overhead join and see what happens. As far as I know, there's no ILS, so hopefully this weather won't be right to the ground. Doesn't look like it is. Miles to go. Very easy day, very easy. Ten past one in the afternoon local time. We'll see if we can sell that racetrack. I doubt it, but wind's changed as we got a bit lower. It's coming across from our left. Miles. Two and a half thousand feet. I think that might be it. Is that it? There it is. Just in the airs there. A couple of options. We can either make a right, turn right before the airport, join the circuit in a left-hand pattern for on left downwind, or we can overfly it, join on a right downwind. We could overfly it, turn the runway heading, the opposite of the runway heading, and do a teardrop join. But I think what I'll do is I'll fly over it and join on right downwind. bit of power back on now. See a racetrack. I've just turned the nav off. I'm just going to fly ahead in now. Up to 2000. Strange square of forest there. Right, turn that autopilot off, kick off the yaw damper. We'll drop flaps. Can't drop flaps yet because I'm still in 850 mod. Drop flaps now because I plan to be a short base like this. In fact, it'll probably be a straight base onto final. Landing lights are on. See if we can spot that runway anywhere. In fact, I think I might have overcooked it a little bit. Didn't fly far enough. Slowed down, I'm dropping out of the sky. That's okay, it's got the power to get us back up. Drop the wheels. Get the flight director off. I've got a bit of a crosswind. 12 knots.
500.
I'm expecting him now. These trees. Down. Flaps to take off. Full power. Knots. Up we go. Wheels coming up. Interesting, that lack of preparation there. Flaps up. Feet on the autopilot. Yaw damper back on, and we're going to flick to nav mode again. But there's no racetrack, disappointed. Lights are out. Right, we'll get back up to a cruise altitude and I'll see you on the approach to a final destination. Okay, we're about 20 miles from a destination, and what we're going to do is, this has an ILS system, so we going to, I've already programmed in the approach. If I activate it, so now we've got a bit further to go, but it's literally going to fly us onto the ILS. Set the ILS at 109.7, or in England decimal 7, and we're going to descend. The GPA, you can see airfields here. We're going to fly up to the first waypoint and then follow that in directly for runway 16 left. What you can actually do is on the GPS if you flick the FMS button. If I can get it to do it. I'll press it first. To work now, but you can go through various menus on it. It might be because I've activated this approach, but the waypoint information. That's the approach. We're going to, BCA 15 is what we're going to fly. Settings and whatnot in there, but if you go into the last menu, which is the nearest menu, it gives us some more information in there. All the airports nearby, nearest 4, nearest NDB, gives us the frequencies there. So there, it's given us the all information for the airport, length of runway, all the frequencies for the tower, and the ILS 16 left frequency 109.7. So that's what we've got programmed in. It doesn't give us what heading runway is on, so I've just dumped in 160. It should be okay with that. Flip back to map. We're slowing and descending. I'm going to fly at about 2,000 feet. A lot of small islands here. We're getting bumpy as well. Potentially this could be a tailwind landing, but it's only very light. It's only 3 knots, so. We're getting the little towns. We're now into the, looks like, building up to cities. Further we get north. Still something not quite right. That's obviously a port, and they've put a farm there, and it looks like there's a missing texture on top of that roof. But it's not bad, I suppose, for all autogen. There's nothing I don't think there's anything specifically modelled. It's all autogen. Still in a bit of cloud. The airfield. very, very bumpy. To that fog. Take it out of 850 mode. Technically, I could just make a right now and still pick up the ILS. I think I'll let it follow the approach procedure. A bit of a screen tear then. Again. This is really going to be a tight turn, so we're probably not going to pick it up until way down here. Reset the altimeter for local. Once we get established on the correct path, we'll flip from GPS to the localizer. I'll slow it down, help it with this turn a little bit. Okay, so it's taking me through, it's literally skipping 14, BCA 14, which is, because I was within a mile when it changed. Tell me 166 on the GPS is the heading it wants to fly. Wind's only 3 knots, so it should be okay. I'm going to do now is I'm just going to flip this CDI to 1, leave the nav on, and it's going to take me on the VOA. We're well below the glide slope, and I just need to change the course to 166. Nav off, put the approach on. Okay, I'm going to pull one stage of flaps down. And now the green glide slope is one ball above the norm, so I'll bring the wheels down. Landing lights to on, let's do the taxi lights on. Fly an approach on the autopilot in this, you just help it with the throttle, you just help it. If it wants to descend a little bit, you just help it. We'll take the yaw damper off in preparation for taking the autopilot off. full flap. Help it with a bit of power, we want about 90-95 knots approach speed. Bang on the glide slope. Slightly offset on the needle, but that's just the wind. It's the autopilot fighting against the crosswind. Helping it, it's dropping, wants to drop below glide slope, so it's nosing down slightly, which pulls our speed up, so just helping it with the throttle, trying to keep it at
90.
Now it wants to nose up a bit. Trim's all right, so we'll disengage. Pull that power off. Reverse thrust. Use any brakes there. Slow it down a bit for this turn down this taxiway here. Let's go and park up somewhere. That was ILS autopilot approach. I only cocked it up at the last minute. Went a bit off the centre line, but. Control tower here. Oh, it's over there. We'll park near the control tower, I think. Okay, so landing lights two off. Flaps up. Might try doing for the next video is turning the traffic up. I've got it on medium, but there's not much about. I think if I turn it on to high and just see how it copes, might give us a few more problems. But should be more traffic now. We're getting to bigger populated areas, you would think, anyway. Fuel, don't need fuel, no, I've got plenty of fuel. might be a big airport at this. There's a couple of runways. But there's no buildings. Park it up here. Parking back on. There we go, that's episode 12 of my Round the World Tour. Be sure to join again for episode 13, where we'll fly, well, wherever we choose. Thanks again, bye bye.